Hey guys, Dustin with Custom Offsets here. Today I'm joined by a special guest. This is Zach from Nineline.
What's going on, guys?
And we're back with another episode of From the Gallery. So if you don't know what that is, that's where we take your gallery ads, rate them on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being not so hot, 10 being super duper awesome. Before we do that, wheelstyresuspensioncustomoffsets.com. Also, the reason Zach is here is because we actually partnered on a giveaway.
That's right.
Tell the people about it.
All right, we got a giveaway going on right now. To enter, all you got to do is go to either nineLineApparel.com, CustomOffsets.com, or AnthemOffroad.com.
Yep, all three of the websites. So.
Buy the shirt, and it enters you for a chance to win a full build package. Wheels, tires, and lift kit. And I think this time it's Toyo tires, Anthem Offroad wheels, and Ready Lift.
Correct.
So not skimping on anything there.
Yeah, it's a great package all around. Ready to jump into it?
Let's do this.
All right, up first is a 2001 Toyota Tacoma Archon Alexander's in a 24x14, which is a massive wheel for a Tacoma.
Huge.
35, 13.5 amp mud terrain MTs and a 7-inch suspension, 3-inch body lift.
On a Tacoma.
That's a big Tacoma.
That is, so I actually have this wheel and tire set up on my personal truck.
Sure.
With the Alexander's and the amp, the Attack MTs. And I kicked, but a little noisy, but not 24s.
And I was just gonna say, both of those together are a super great value because, I mean, together you're talking, what, $3,000-ish bucks for both of them. And this is a 24, 14, and a 35, so that's a big boy. Looks like he's got a 5-inch, I assume that's supposed to be Rough Country, adjustable Bilstein coils, 1.5-inch body lift, and 3-inch rear lift shackles. And he's got wheel spacers on it besides, so.
I'm gonna take a point off for his spelling.
Absolutely massive, a little lean going on there, which I'm not a super huge fan of, or a little squat, I should say. Looks like he's got some RGB going on up in the headlights there. Really good photos though. Man, I just cannot get over how massive the wheel and tire is on this thing.
On a Tacoma of all things, an 01 Tacoma. Like, that's a lot of investment.
Yeah.
Tacoma as well.
Yeah, I think I've seen what I need to see. Are you ready to rate it?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, 7. Yep. It's neat, but for me, When you make these Tacomas that big and you put that big of a wheel and tire on it, it looks like a Hot Wheels toy.
Yeah, it's not comical, but almost like novelty.
Yeah.
Right? You're going with this 24-inch wheel, you know, I mean, negative 81 offset on a Tacoma.
And the wheel spacers besides.
Yeah, yeah, it's almost like you took the body of that Tacoma and it looks like you set it on like a Tundra frame just because the stance is just so aggressive.
Correct.
So
it's neat, it's just not my taste, you know. Yeah. Up next. 2004 Dodge Ram 2500 Fuel Renegades 20x14-76 with a Mickey Thompson Baja MTZ in a 38x15.5 and another body and suspension. So this time 6-inch suspension, 3-inch body lift on this one.
9 inches of total width.
Yeah. You can already clear massive amounts of tire on Dodge trucks to begin with. And then he picked the whole thing up 9 inches so he could clear even bigger tires.
Yeah.
Looks like he's a member of Team Stance here as well.
Yeah.
Which is super cool. A blacked out literally everything on this thing. Massive front bumper with all the LED light stuff in there. Blacked out housings on the headlights. Thank God he did blacked out housings and not tinted the lenses.
Yes, yes.
That's one of like my biggest pet peeves, man, is it's so easy to black out housings now that it just don't tint your headlights. It's bad. You'll hate it, I promise.
Little custom grill action going on there. The little tribal stuff going on in the grill.
Yeah, it's super neat. And then even up into the hood here, he's got the cowl induction, so. Plus, he left his tow mirrors down.
It's automatic 2 points.
Yeah, correct. All right, I'm ready to go if you are.
Yeah.
All right, 3, 2, 1, 8. 7.5. Yep, I figured we'd be close. I like that everything flows together well. The black on black looks good. Anytime you
super
murder
clean.
A, yeah, you murder a truck, it looks fantastic.
It's super clean. It looks like, you know, he left the chrome on with just like the Ram 2500, but you've got the black and milled wheels.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got that little bit, you know, tying together there.
Correct.
All around, it's just a clean truck. Such a big truck, 9 inches of lift on that 2500. See, from the front, the wheels look proportional from the profile view. Even being 38, so they're such large trucks.
Yeah, the tires look small.
Also, he's got some nuts hanging down there on the back.
I think those are actual nuts, though. They're not like truck
nuts. Not the truck nuts, yeah. No, cool. Overall, a clean truck.
Yeah, it's neat. Up next. Ooh, you gotta hit me right in the feels here. 2016 GMC Sierra 2500 HD, fuel forged in a 24x14. Those are the F29s, of course. And then amp tires again, this time the MT and a 37, 13.5 with a 9-inch Cognito suspension lift. This thing's hot.
Yeah, it's different. Yeah. It's clean with just like the right amount. Like, you know, he's got the gold wheels mm-hmm. with gold accents going up on the front, but there's like a shackles and yep. everything.
And someone's gonna be in the comments, be like, bro, you always talk about this, but I am a sucker for OLED headlights and taillights.
Like, really?
I can't explain why you do either. I'm not a huge fan.
Really?
I'm not a huge fan, but it works.
Yeah, correct. Yep, it ties in together really well. Custom grill action.
Yeah.
Looks like he's got some, I'm assuming, mesh inserts in the front bumper there. Oh, yeah,
the front view. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yep. Some, so
and
some
just bringing some more of those gold accents.
Correct.
In there.
That's a classic photo at the lumberyard, throwing some 4x4s in there, you know. Other than that, it looks good.
A little bit of rubbing and yeah. trimming.
I would expect some rub with that, you know. Cool. I'm ready to rate it if you are.
Yeah.
All right. 3, 2, 1, 7. 9. I love this thing. It's hot. The headlights do it for me. It's all blacked out with that little sprinkle of color in there. I think it looks good.
I like the accents with the golden stuff. And just like anybody with a truck, you're never finished with it.
Correct.
And I feel like this guy's probably still working on it. He's got that custom front bumper going on. He's still got the stock bumper in the rear.
Yep.
But he's got the black, that looks like the taillight covers.
Yeah.
All right. And that automatically reduced it for me. My very first truck, my Ford Ranger I had when I was a senior in high school, I had the blackout taillight and headlight covers, which is just obnoxious. Right? You get pulled over all the time.
You let no light through. Yeah. Absolutely.
So. But it is a clean truck, and I have a feeling the guy's probably still doing stuff to it.
Yeah, I mean, anyone that tells you they're done is a liar.
Absolutely. So.
Up next is a 2015 Ford F-150, fuel-forged again, this time the FF16, 24x14s, Delente DX9s, the MT tire there in a 325-45, which is roughly a 35.5, and then a King 7-inch suspension lift kit. I hope that's just the angle and it's not that he's got that much squat going on. Let's take a look here. Beautiful wheels. Custom front grille there. Looks like he's got some headlight action.
You got a couple LED cubes going on in the front
bumper.
There's
only like 1 or 15 up there. It doesn't look nearly as squatted that
way. No, I think the angle of that driveway is really making it look extreme.
Yep. I see he's got the rear diff cover in there as well, which is super cool.
A little accent.
Yep.
He's a Texas boy, which is always good.
Yep. Ooh. I'm a sucker for that, only because I know how much work it is to put those in.
Is that in the headliner?
Yeah, so what they do is they take a fiber optic light, you know, and then they punch holes in it and send it through. It looks really cool, and then they get them to like twinkle and stuff like stars. It takes forever to do. I'm ready to rate it if you are.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, 8.
8.
Yep.
Overall, it's a clean build.
Correct.
I like the forged wheels, but that satin finish.
Yeah.
Also easier on the maintenance.
Much easier. Much easier on the maintenance. Wheel.
Yeah, he's got the black spike lug nuts in there, which pop off a little bit. I kind of like the 15 LED cubes in the front bumper for some reason.
It doesn't.
It
look
looks
bad.
Different than just having a giant 52 inch curved
bar,
light bar.
Yep.
It's different. Little details. Lift your truck. You're gonna see that rear diff cover. Put an aftermarket rear diff cover on there.
Yep.
Looks like it's also a satin finish, matches with the wheels. The headliner thing, I'll be honest, couldn't care less. But the rest of it, I think it's a clean build. He's got really high-end wheels, high-end lift.
Yep.
They're sparing no expense on stuff like that.
Correct.
I'm not familiar with those tires. I mean, is that a...
They are a little bit more price-conscious tire brand. You're talking basically a 35-inch tire for $1,500.
So. Okay.
All right, last but not least, a 1988 Chevy K3500 crew cab. I believe that's a long box. It's on American Force Fallouts in 22x14s, Centennial Dirt Commander MTs in a 37-13.5, and a 9.5 Super Lift suspension lift, which is literally just stack the leaf springs.
Wow.
This thing is huge. Couple of pictures right on the old beach there. Is it green? It looks OD green.
Green. I thought it was black.
Yeah, it looks like it's OD green.
And that is definitely long. That is a land yacht.
That is a gigantic truck.
The people in the front seat are getting to their destination 30 minutes before anything in the bed.
Yep, exactly. Oh, man. Beautifully done, though. Like, it is that olive drab green, tinted out the windows. Other than that, really super stock body truck, which is cool. I actually prefer that with these older trucks. Gosh, could you imagine trying to turn that thing around, though?
No, absolutely not. You need that whole beach.
For real. Yep. Beautiful wheel choice. Of course, Forces always look great. Looks like he's got maybe a little LED action up in the front there.
Yeah, just some touches of modern. Looks like he's got a winch going on in the bumper.
Yeah, just the perfect amount of form.
Look at those spring packs.
Yeah, stacks of leaf springs. Not really a whole lot else to say about this one. Let's rate it.
I'm ready.
Three, two, one, 9. 6.5. And I feel so bad doing it. I do, because this is really well done. One of my big sticklers when I do these from the galleries is I like to see trucks that follow the same kind of build theme, mm-hmm. right? And this one to me is like, everything was made really form and function. He's got the brush guard style bumper with the winch, and then it's on forces.
That's what I kind of like about it. You've got this old, like, the truck's a tank.
Yeah,
right?
It's
like,
gigantic.
It's gigantic,
correct.
It's a tank. It looks like it's in really good shape.
Yeah.
Right? Like, there's not really close-up things. I mean, it doesn't look like anything's rotted out or
yep.
anything. And so I like that mix of that old with the new,
mm-hmm.
with the forces.
Sure.
I think that just, it looks kind of cool. Maybe on a black wheel.
That I can see.
Instead
yep.
of the chrome. Polish. I dig it. I mean, it's got to be a pain to drive.
Oh, yeah. It's neat. Like I said, I feel bad doing it. It's just not my style.
Yeah.
But that's what makes them so awesome, right? Is it, you know, it doesn't really make a, it's all about who built it and what they
yeah.
want to do with it. So cool. Well, that's another episode of From the Gallery, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you to Zach for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
And for partnering with us on that giveaway. So again, if you didn't catch it before, customoffsets.com/giveaway to get entered. Wheels, tires, and suspension, of course, on this one, or the 9Liner website, or the Anthem website as well. And then last but not least, if you want the chance for your truck to be featured, customoffsets.com/ad is where you're gonna wanna do that. That's it.
One day we'll see my truck on there. It's in the gallery.
I tried to get him to add it, but he wouldn't.
It's okay, it's okay, it's fine.
All right, we're out, peace.